वेलकम बैक दोस्तों। आज हम पार्ट 10 ऑफ आवर रिवीजन फॉर द यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट एनवायरनमेंट एंड एकोलॉजी देखेंगे, है ना। तो आज का दिस इज लाइक ए फाइनल पार्ट रिगार्डिंग द पोल्यूशन, एनर्जी, वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट, क्लाइमेट चेंज, टेक्नोलॉजी एंड डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। चलो आज का कंटेंट देख लेंगे। सो यू विल सी अबाउट द एनडीआरएफ, इट इज ट्रेनिंग द 15,000 स्टाफ इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ कोरोना वायरस, ओके। एंड हम ये डिफरेंस बिटवीन एलईडी एंड सीएफएल क्या है एंड हाउ इट इज इंपैक्टिंग एनवायरनमेंट, वी विल आल्सो लुक इनटू दैट। लेटर वी विल लुक एट द दिल्लीज वाटर, हाउ इट इज नॉट कंफर्मिंग विद द आईएसओ स्टैंडर्ड्स। लेटर वी लुक एट द यूरेनियम कंटामिनेशन इन द ग्राउंड वाटर। वी विल लुक एट द ब्लैक कार्बन लेवल्स दैट आर रेजिंग इन द हिमालयन ग्लेशियर्स एंड वॉट इज इट्स इम्पैक्ट, ओके। हम उसके बाद कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज देखेंगे, हाउ कलरिंग इज गिवन अकॉर्डिंग टू द polluting levels. We will also look about the state disaster response fund. Later we will look about the renewable hybrid energy systems. So this is similar to like the hybrid cars, okay. Later we look at the Vaishno Devi, which has now has its own disaster response force. Later we look about the ocean energy declared as the renewable energy by the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change. You'll also look about the International Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure. Recently, there is high news about the locust attacks. So, we'll see about that. And there is also another insect that is impacting the agriculture. That is the fall armyworm. And there is one UNESCO site that has been hugely impacted by coral bleaching. Okay, Great Barrier Reef. Later we will look at the dead zones in the Gulf of Mexico and the reason for its occurrence. Later we will look at the avian botulism. वो क्या है, किसके वजह से होता है, पूरा देख लेंगे। Then final two topics are the first resilient Kerala program. So recently because of the Kerala floods and how World Bank is helping this, okay, to cope up with the disaster. And finally we will look about the waste management accelerator for aspiring women enterprise summit, okay. So first topic is the NDRF, that is the National Disaster Response Force. It has trained like more than 15,000 staff because in the context of the COVID-19 outbreak. So little bit background about our force. This has been set up under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Okay. So what is its purpose for the addressing the both natural and man-made disasters? So this comes under Ministry of Home Affairs. This is very important. So difference between LED and CFL. CFL, how does it produce light? यहाँ पे क्या होता है? There is a mercury vapor. So when you on the CFL light, the mercury vapor inside that tube will get ionized. Okay. So this ionized mercury vapor will be producing ultraviolet rays. But the coating on the outer part of the bulb is done by the phosphorus, okay. So when this ultraviolet rays impacts or collides with the phosphorus coating, it gives the visible light, okay. This is how the working of CFL. But kya hai, the major issue with this is the context of e-waste, and this is producing the mercury vapor into environment, which is hazard. While if we compare this with the LED, this LED uses the PN junction diode and destruction, that is the disposal of this LED, is very much easier compared to CFL, okay. And in the context of science, we see that LED saves up to 80% of the electricity bill, okay. And it is recyclable and the brightness remains same even after long term, okay. The next topic is Delhi is not conforming with the ISO standards, okay, of Delhi water, right. So Bureau of Indian Standards, we have one standard, that is the IS 10500 2012. So what does it say? It gives a specification regarding the drinking water. So the water sample that has been collected by the Delhi is not conforming with these standards, okay. So Supreme Court has sorted the report on the same. So next topic is about uranium contamination in groundwater. So there was a report in the parliament about this contamination. So as we seen previously about the standards, that is the 10500 2012 about drinking water, right. So according to this, acceptable level is 0.03 mg per liter. That is the this is in concurrence with the WHO guidelines, right? But in some area this is exceeding. For example, in these areas like the Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, and Jammu Kashmir. The next topic is about black carbon. See, black carbon is second largest contributor to climate change after CO2. So how does it produce? It produces due to incomplete combustion of the fossil fuels. So recently there were findings that the black carbon concentration near Gangotri Glacier rose 400 times. This is an area of concern in summer due to forest fires, stubble burning from the agriculture waste and triggered glacier melt. How? Because when it falls on the earth, what happens? It darkens the snow and the ice. So, kya hota hai? Ice has the highest albedo, that is the amount of the light that is reflected back. Okay. So, when this reducing the albedo, the amount of the heat that is retained increases, and this hastens or increases the melting. Okay. Which is a serious threat. See, here India is the second largest emitter of the black carbon in the world. The next topic is about the categorization of industries. We already seen this. Let us see it again. So this is given by the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change. So this this categorization is done depending on the emissions from the air pollution, effluents from the water, and hazardous waste that are generated. So depending on this, the pollution load is calculated. Okay, according to that, different categories to the industries are given. For example. If the rating is the value is about 60, it is categorized under red. Okay, so such kind of industries include cement, pharmaceutical, sugar, paper, pulp, nuclear power plants, firecrackers, etc. Okay, and if the value is between 41 to 59, this is called as the orange. So this is like little bit severe compared to the red. Okay, so these kind of industries include glass manufacturing, coal washeries, stone crushers, aluminum copper extraction process, and scrap industry. Later, the next one is about the green, where the value is between the 21 to 40. These include the processing of aluminum utensils, steel furniture, soap manufacturing, tea processing, etc. And finally, white, which is like less polluting industries. So these include practically non-polluting. Okay. So the next topic is about state disaster response fund. So Ministry of Home Affairs so decided to treat the COVID-19 as a notified disaster. Okay. So what is this fund? So this fund has been constituted under the 2005 Act, that is the Disaster Management Act, right? So that aids that helps with the states by giving the funds. So its composition kya hota hai? It contributes 75% to the states. To the states in general category, while 90% is special category. Okay, so this special category include kya include hota hai, like northeastern states, Sikkim, Himachal Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. So center releases the funds in two in equal installments. Okay, on the recommendation of Financial Commission. So disaster kaise cover hote hain iske niche cyclones, droughts, tsunamis, hailstorms, landslides, avalanches. Pest attacks. Please remember pest attacks in the context of locust attack. Okay. The next one. So the yahan pe kya hai? So almost like a grant in aid. The share of government of India to this state's response fund is treated as a grant in aid. Next topic is about the renewable hybrid energy systems. The reason why I said it's similar to hybrid cars, like in hybrid cars, mein kya karte hain? Where they use the general gasoline engine, and the part of that energy is also used to generate electricity that is stored in the fuel cells, right? And that energy that is stored will be used again to give the torque to the tires or to run the vehicle. Similarly, yahan pe in renewable hybrid energy systems, we have two or more renewable energy sources that are mixed to provide an efficient system. For example, बायोमास विंड फ्यूल सेल. सो यहाँ पे फोटोवोल्टाइक सेल अरे इज कपल्ड विद द विंड टर्बाइन हाइड्रो विंड एनर्जी सिस्टम्स. ओके सो दिस नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज अबाउट द वैष्णो देवी श्राइन विच हैज सेपरेट फोर्स डिजास्टर रिस्पॉन्स फोर्स. ओके प्लीज लुक एट द जियोग्राफिकल लोकेशन ऑफ सच कल्चरल नो कल्चरल इंपॉर्टेंट साइट्स. सो दिस इज लोकेटेड टॉप ऑफ त्रिकुटा हिल्स. दिस इज देयर इन रेजाई डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज अबाउट ओशन एनर्जी विच इज बीन डिक्लेयर्ड एज रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. सो रिसेंटली मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी इट हैज स्टेटेड दैट एनर्जी प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ ओशन एनर्जी. इट माइट बी टाइडल वेव ओशन एनी थर्मल राइट एनी सोर्स फ्रॉम दिस ओशन विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी. ओके सो वी हैव वन काइंड ऑफ एनर्जी कॉल्ड एज ओशन थर्मल एनर्जी कन्वर्शन. व्हाट हैपेंस इज सी द टर्म थर्मल. So it takes the advantage of thermal difference, that is the temperature difference at different levels of ocean. For example, like the top layer might be having at a higher temperatures while compared to the bottom layers or the under layers. Like if there is like 15 to 20 degrees difference, using a technology we can harness the temperature difference and produce renewable energy. Okay, theoretically we have like 180,000 megawatts such potential. सो इसमें देर आर टू टाइप्स. वन इज क्लोज साइकिल मेथड. यहाँ पे क्या होता है वैक्यूम फ्लूइड लाइक अमोनिया इज पंप टू द हीट एक्सचेंजर एंड वेपराइज दैट रन्स द टर्बाइन. सो टर्बाइन रन करता है एंड विल गेट द पावर. इन ओपन साइकिल सिस्टम क्या होता है द वार्म सरफेस वाटर इज प्रेशराइज्ड इन द वैक्यूम चैम्बर एंड कन्वर्टेड टू स्टीम टू रन द टर्बाइन. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज अबाउट द इंटरनेशनल कोएलिशन. इट इज कोएलिशन मतलब पार्टनरशिप है फॉर डिजास्टर रेजिलियंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. So why? Because this coalition is used as a platform to exchange in knowledge, best practices, to tackle the disasters and the climate change effectively in the context of the infrastructure to build resilient infrastructure. Remember, resilient infrastructure is also one of the goals of sustainable development goals. Okay. So this mechanism assists countries to upgrade their capacities and practices with regard to the infrastructure development in this context. So few concrete initiatives like they have taken in the Sendai framework, sustainable development and climate change adaptation. So in the context of this resilient infrastructure. The next topic is the locust attack. So this has gained significance in the recent past. So very much news in the current affairs. So FAO has given three hotspots of these attacks, that is the Horn of in the region of the Horn of Africa, Red Sea area, and this Southwest Asia. Why this region? Because it provides such kind of temperatures where these locusts can breed and multiply in their numbers, right? So little bit information about the FAO. This is established in 1945. Its headquarters is in Rome, that is in Italy, and its goal is to provide the food security. It is also one of the goals of sustainable development goals for everyone, and access to high quality food. So FAO produces different reports. Do you remember UPSC is one of the favorite areas about the reports. It releases state of world report regarding the food, agriculture, fisheries, forestry and natural resources, right? So there is another important attack like this seen in news, that is about the fall armyworm. So this has been seen in the context of attack on happening in the maize crop in Odisha. Okay, so this time the Odisha has taken proper management and precautions to avoid this. So this is very much well tackled. So this fall armyworm is generally a subtropic, belongs to a native to subtropic regions of America. Okay, so it is first detected in the African continent in 2016. Later it spread to different areas. So it can attack like 80 types of crops including bajra, jawar, paddy, wheat, etc. Right, so in India it is first reported in Karnataka. So FAO, that is the Food and Agriculture Organization, it also launched one global action for the FAW control as a response to international threat posed by this army bomb, right? The next topic is about the coral bleaching that is impacting the UNESCO site. It is a Great Barrier Reef. Okay, so this is important because it is a home for 3000 coral reefs, 600 continental islands and 1625 types of fish. The variety of biodiversity here is very great significance. So scientists have warned that it is in the Great Barrier Reef is in the critical period because of the heat stress. Okay, and as I said, it is one of the World Heritage Site. So regarding the coral reefs, it is called as a tropical rainforest of the sea because of the diversity it holds. In India, majorly we see the coral reefs in Park Bay, Gulf of Mannar, Gulf of Kutch, Andaman Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep Islands, right? So among these coral reefs, Lakshadweep Reef is an example of atoll. Atoll is one type of coral reef, right? You see here, coral reefs is protected under the Schedule 1, right, of the Indian Wildlife Protection Act. The next topic is about the dead zones in the Gulf of Mexico. So recently, the spring's record rainfall would produce one of the largest ever dead zones in Gulf of Mexico that has been reported. Okay, what are these? These are the unoxygenated, like the content of oxygen is very much less because of eutrophication, right? Why this eutrophication has occurred? Because of the nutrient that has been flowing from the Mississippi River that caused this particular Gulf of region Mexico as a dead zone. Next topic is about the avian botulism. Okay, avian ka matlab kya hai? Bird origin. Okay, so recently they have found that the 18,000 birds have been died in the Rajasthan Sambar Lake because of this avian botulism. So kya hai botulinum? So there is one bacteria called as Clostridium botulinum which produces certain kind of neuromuscular illness in these birds. So this has caused death of these 18,000 birds, right? So this bacteria is commonly found in soil, rivers and seawater, right? So the first Resilient Kerala program has started. So this is an association with the Government of India, Kerala and World Bank, which has signed a loan agreement of 250 million, okay, to enhance the state resilience against the impact of the natural disasters and climate change. So this has come post the floods that have occurred in the Kerala. The next topic is about the Waste Management Accelerator for Aspiring Women Entrepreneurs Summit. So this summit has taken place in November-December 2019. So this has been jointly organized by AICT, that is All India Council for Technical Education, and Institute of Waste Management, that is there in Jaipur. So what does it do? It aims at promoting the entrepreneurship in the waste management, providing alternatives to single-use plastic, right? So India has planned to completely remove the single-use plastic by 2030. Please remember this topic, right? So please do share your feedback and focus on your preparation continuously, right? And do use these videos like when you take certain break, like right lunchtime, right? So let us meet in this next part, right? Till then, take care. Thank you.